Arizona Secretary of State Katie Hobbs sent a letter to the Arizona Attorney General yesterday asking him to please investigate Donald Trump and, of course, his close allies, Rudy Giuliani and possibly even Sidney Powell, for possible election interference in the state of Arizona. Here's what happened in case you missed it. Last week, it was revealed that both the Trump White House and Rudy Giuliani, on separate occasions and on multiple occasions, made phone calls to officials in the state of Arizona following the November election, trying to get them to stop the counting. In fact, it got so bad. Let me read this. This is from the Arizona Central. This is crazy. The Arizona Republic detailed two separate attempts by Trump to reach Republican Supervisor Clint Hickman in the weeks after the election as the president's allies sought to alter the election results in a state he narrowly lost to Democrat Joe Biden. At the time, Hickman was chairman of the Board of Supervisors, the elected body that oversees elections in the state's most populous county, Maricopa. Hickman received the first call from the White House switchboard on December 31st while he was out celebrating the coming New Year with his wife and friends. He let the call go to voicemail. Second call came on the night of January 3rd after the Washington Post published a recording of Trump's hour-long phone call with Georgia's Secretary of State. Hickman sought to avoid talking to the president because of ongoing litigation, and he let the call go to voicemail. And yes, for the record, the Arizona Republic does in fact have those voicemails where you can hear what they were trying to do. Then, of course, Rudy Giuliani steps in. He starts texting and calling the chairwoman of the Arizona Republican Party, trying to get her to somehow interfere, stop the counting of the votes. Honestly, it is pretty much, you know, identical to what these idiots were doing over in Georgia, trying to get them to stop the votes, trying to get them to go find the votes, as Trump said. And let's not forget, Trump is already under criminal investigation in Georgia. I know we all get distracted with New York, but there have been two grand juries impaneled in the state of Georgia regarding Donald Trump's potential election interference in that state. That's a big deal that everybody seems to have forgotten about. And now the same thing might happen in Arizona. There's a catch here. Arizona's attorney general, man by the name of, let me see if I can find it here. It's Brenna. Brenna is running for U.S. Senate as a Republican. So he's got a lot at stake here. He can't piss off Republicans enough by investigating Donald Trump, even though Brenna did, in fact, you know, support Arizona's sweeping new voter suppression laws. So he does have that in his back pocket. But then again, you also have Secretary of State Katie Hobbs, the one calling for the investigation, who is going to be running for Arizona governor. So she wants to also get some brownie points here. However, I do think that her claims are valid. The evidence is available. You can go listen to those voicemails if you would like to. So we know that they did in fact try to get them to stop the counting in Maricopa County, the same county that is now being audited by the folks at Cyber Ninjas. So yeah, I would say that this warrants an investigation, but considering it would have to be launched by the Republican Attorney General, I don't think we're ever actually going to get one. If you can't get enough Ring of Fire, we encourage everyone to subscribe to our channel for fresh video content 7 days a week. And for even more from me, you can follow me on all social media outlets, Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram at Farron Balanced.